History of mathematics. Every culture on earth has developed some mathematics. In some cases, this mathematics has spread from one culture to another. Now, there is one predominant international mathematics, and this mathematics has quite a history. It has roots in ancient Egypt and Babylonia, then grew rapidly in ancient Greece. Mathematics, written in ancient Greek, was translated into Arabic. About the same time, some mathematics of India was translated into Arabic. Later, some of this mathematics was translated into Latin and became the mathematics of Western Europe. Over a period of several hundred years, it became the mathematics of the world. There are other places in the world that developed significant mathematics, such as China, Southern India, and Japan, and they are interesting to study. But the mathematics of the other region have not had much influence on current international mathematics. There is, of course, much mathematics being done this and other regions. But it is not the traditional math of the regions, but international mathematics. In 35,000 BC, first notched tally bones is a piece of wood in which notches were cut as a method of recording numbers. When it is used as a record of payments, the stick was split across the notches. In Sumerian earliest documented counting and measuring system. In Egyptian earliest fully developed base 10 number system. Sumerian multiplication table, geometrical exercises and division problem. 2000 up to 1800 BC Egyptian earliest. Papyri, numeration system, and arithmetic. 1800 to 1600 BC, Babylonian clay tablets, dealing with fraction, algebra, and equation. 1650 BC, Egyptian rin, papyrus, instructional manual in arithmetic, geometry, unit, fraction, etc. 624 to 546 BC, Thales, early developed in geometry including work on similar and right triangles. 570 to 495 BC, Pythagoras' theorem. 500 BC, Hippasus discovered potential existence of the irrational numbers. 460 to 370 BC, Democritus, development in geometry and fractions, volume of Pacun. 428 to 348, Plato, Platonic solid statements of three classical problem, popularizer of math, logical method, 384 to 322 BC, acted reasoning, 300 BC, Euclid, definitive statement of classical geometry, Euclidean, use of auction, many formulas, proof and theorem, like Euclid's theorem on infinitude of primes. 212 BC, Archimedes formulas for areas of regular shape. 90 to 168 AD, develop even more detailed trigonometry tablets.
The 17th century saw an unprecedented explosion of mathematical and scientific ideas across Europe. Galileo observed the moons of Jupiter in orbit about the planet. Using a telescope, based on a toy imported from Holland, Tycho Brahe had gathered an enormous quantity of the mathematical data describing the position of the planets in the sky. Through his position as Brahe's assistant, Johannes Kepler was first exposed to the series interacted with the topic of planetary motion. Kepler's calculations were made simpler by the contemporaneous inventions of logarithm by John Napier and Jos Burgi. Kepler succeeded in formulating mathematical laws of planetary motion. The analytic geometry developed by René Descartes allowed those orbits to be plotted on a graph in Cartesian coordinates. Simon Stevens created the basis for modern decimal notation capable of describing all numbers, whether rational or irrational.
Earlier work by many predecessors, Isaac Newton discovered the law of physics explaining Kepler's law and brought together the concept known as calculus. Tapos na yan.
Independently, Gottfried Wilhelm Leibniz, who is arguably one of the most important mathematicians on the 17th century, developed calculus, and much of the calculus notation still in use today. Science and mathematics had become international endeavor which would soon spread over the entire world. In addition to the application of mathematics to the studies of the heavens, applied mathematics began to expand into new eras, with the correspondence of Thierry Fermat and Blaise Pascal. Pascal and Fermat set the groundwork for the investigation of probability theory and the corresponding rules of combinatorics. In their discussions over a game of gambling, Pascal with his wager attempted to use the newly developing probability theory to argue for a life devoted to religion, on the grounds that even if the probability of success was small, the rewards were infinite. In some sense, this foreshadowed the development of utility theory in the 18th to 19th century.
18th century. The most influential mathematicians of the 18th century was arguably Leonhard Euler. His contribution ranged from founding the study of graph theory with the 7 digits of Coinsbridge problem to standardizing many modern mathematical terms in notation.
For example, he named the square root of minus 1 with the symbol, and he popularized the use of the Greek letter to stand for the ratio of a circle's circumference to its diameter. He made numerous contribution to the study of topology, graph theory, calculus, combinatorics, and complex analysis, as evidenced by the multitude of theorems and notation named for him. Other important European mathematicians of the 18th century included Joseph Louis Lagrange, who did pioneering work in the number theory, algebra, differential calculus, in the calculus of variation in Laplace, who, in the age of Napoleon, did important work on the foundation of celestial mechanics and statistics.
About the 19th century, mathematics became increasingly abstract in the 19th century. Did Carl Friedrich Gauss in 1775. This
century saw the development of the two forms of non-Euclidean geometry, where the parallel postulate of Euclidean geometry no longer holds. The Russian mathematician Nikolai Ivanovich Blavatsky and his rival, the Hungarian mathematician Janos Bolyai, independently defined and studied hyperbolic geometry, where uniqueness of parallel no longer holds. In this geometry, the sum of angles in the triangle add to less than 180. Elliptic geometry was developed later in the 19th century by the German mathematician Bernhard Mann. Here no parallel can be found and the angles in a triangle add up to more than 180 degrees. Riemann also developed Riemann geometry, which unfinds and vastly generalized the three types of geometry, and he defined the concept of a manifold, which generalized the idea of curves and surface. The 19th century saw the beginning of great deal of abstract algebra. Hermann Grassmann in Germany gave a first version of vector space. William Rowan Hamilton in Ireland developed non-commutative algebra. The British mathematician George Boole devised an algebra that soon evolved into what is now called Boolean algebra, in which the only numbers were 0 and 1.
Boolean algebra is the starting point of mathematical logic and has important application in computer science. Agustin Louis Cauchy, Bernhard Riemann, and Karl Weierstrass formulated the calculus in more rigorous fashion. Also, for the first time, the limits of mathematics were explored. Neil Henrik Abel, a Norwegian, and Évariste Galois, a Frenchman, provide that there is no general algebraic method for solving polynomial equation of degree greater than 4, Abel-Ruffini theorem. Other 19th century mathematicians utilized this in their proofs that straight edges and compass alone are not sufficient to trisect an arbitrary angle. To construct the side of a cube twice the volume of a given cube, nor to construct a square equal in area to given circle. Mathematicians had vainly at all of these problems since the time of ancient Greek. On the other hand, the limitation of three dimension in geometry surpassed in the 19th century through consideration of parameter space and hypercomplex number.
The 20th century saw mathematics become a major profession. Every year, thousands of new PhDs in mathematics were awarded, and jobs were available in both teaching and industry. An effort catalogs the areas and application of mathematics was undertaken in Kellin's Encyclopedia.
In a 1900 speech to the International Congress of Mathematicians, David Hilbert set out a list of 23 unsolved problems in mathematics. These problems, spanning many areas of mathematics, form a central focus for much of 20th century mathematics. Today, 10 have been solved, 7 are partially solved, and 2 are still open. The remaining 4 are too loosely formulated to be stated as solved or not.
In 2000, the Clay Mathematics Institute announced the 7 million price problem, and in 2003, the Poincaré conjecture was solved by Grigori Perelman, who declined to accept an award on this point. Most mathematics journals now have online versions as print versions, and many online only journals are launched. There is an increasing drive toward open access publishing versus population by the